Soothe2 has become a staple plugin in many music producers' arsenal. It's a great tool to remove harshness or tame resonant frequencies with. Common use cases are on vocals, guitars, and drums. So, what's in it for us sound designers? In this video, I will show you three creative and functional ways to use Soothe2 in your sound designs. Wouldn't it be great to have a tool that can spark your imagination, let your layers fit together, and make your sound design work better in context? Soothe2 is a plugin that can do all this for you. So let's dive in and see how we can use this plugin for sound design. We start out with two more functional ways to use it and finish it off with one more creative way. So the first way to use Soothe in a more functional way is to use the sidechain function in it. Here we have a soft signature sound that sounds like this. And it's just a softer signature sound created out of a door creak that I really liked. So I have just one sample and just duplicated that, resampled that into four different tracks. So I have a main layer, then I have two mid layers and one bass layer. And I have pitched them differently, panned them, and as you see, did a ton of processing to them. But one thing that you will run into when you use this technique where you have one sample and you create multiple different layers out of that sample is that the different layers will start to clash with each other. They share so much common frequencies with each other, so they will start to mask each other and you will get weird phase issues with it. And yeah, it can be a bit messy. So Soothe is a really great plugin to add some clarity to a sound like this and just add some separation to different layers in it. So what I did here and what I usually do is that I choose one main layer and then have the other layers just sidechained from that layer. And what that will do is that this Soothe that we have on this layer here will get information on what kind of frequencies this sound have that we want to have up front and just reduce those peaking frequencies from this sound and just create more space to it. So if I just bypass all the different Soothes here, it sounds like this. And it's just a slightly more cluttered sound. If I bypass the main layer and the reverbs, you will hear it even clearer. And if I engage them, it sounds like this. Just so much more space to each layer, and you can hear the separation in between the two mid layers on the left and the right and the right side. And if I bypass them, they just fight for the same space. So this is a really great way to use Soothe2 in a functional way. The next way to use Soothe2 in a functional way for your sound design is to tame the tails in your percussive sounds, especially in your big hits. They are often so compressed and limited when you're finished with it that you have brought out a lot of the rumbling tail in it. And you can't really afford to have that in your big sounds like this, because as soon as this hit has like engaged and just slammed, you'd have a lot of other sounds that want to get that place. Around 100 Hz is often kind of crowded with drums and low strings and synths or whatever you have there. So Soothe is a really nice and clean way to take care of those long tails that you just want to tame a little bit. And it's really easy to work with. So we have a big hit here, and I have bypassed the Soothe2, and we listen to it. And there is a really long rumbling tail in there. So if I just engage this, and I have just limit the frequency range here to just work around 100 Hz, and then I have automated the depth here. So I will let through everything and in the beginning and the transient and the body of the sound, but then I just ramp up the depth of Soothe in the tail. So we take a listen to that. And it's just so much cleaner, and you have so much more headroom and space for all the other sounds. So we take it one more time without. And with. Nice and easy way to just tame the tails in your percussive sounds. The third and final way to use Soothe2 for your sound design is in a much more creative way. It has this delta function, and this lets you hear what the plugin removes, all the poking frequencies and all the harshness. But if you just leave delta on, you can really sculpt the sounds in interesting ways, because then you just have the poking frequencies and the harshness to work with. And that creates really new opportunities that's really hard to like put your finger on before you start working with this and experimenting with it. So if we take a listen to this sound, it's just a big sci-fi bram. And if we now engage delta, it sounds like this. So a lot of the core is there still, but you hear this high, weird, noisy stuff, like almost like some percussion stuff all on top of it. And it creates a lot of movement. And that thing is, I can't imagine another way to do that. And you can use this in really creative ways to just have this as one layer of your sound, or just entirely reshape the sound design of your sounds, or have this as a starting point to just sculpt it a little bit. As you see here, I have automated the sharpness and the selectivity, and I have used the filters to just sculpt it a little bit to my likings. So really great way to spark some imagination and some creative uses, and just really, really fun way to use this plugin in a much more creative way than it was intended to. The most common question I get from my students is, how do I know when a sound is finished? To me, this is a really good question, because a creative process don't have a defined finish line. You can change, add, and tweak things forever. And as a full-time sound designer, I create new sounds every day, and I know how hard it can be to decide when a sound is finished. To help you out with this issue, I have created a 7-step checklist that will guide you to finish your sound design faster, easier, and with better results. This simple checklist makes it super easy for you to know if your sound design have everything it needs, or if you have to adjust something in it. You can apply this checklist to any kind of sound design, both in the beginning of the process, so you get a head start of it, and in the end, so you know that your sound design have everything it needs. So go ahead and download the 7-step checklist with a link in the description, have it on your desktop, double check your sound designs with it, and you will avoid to fumble in the dark and not know how and when to finish your sound designs. Thanks a ton for watching this video, and I see you in the next one.